Hey guys, it's Cody for another Tech Tip Tuesday. Today we're talking about the similarities and differences between Braille notetakers and Braille displays. First, let's talk about some similarities. Both Braille notetakers and Braille displays have a refreshable Braille display. They also might both have a Perkins-style keyboard like this one or a QWERTY keyboard. So they tend to look really similar. But what's the difference between them? Well, a Braille notetaker, like a Braille Note Touch or a Braille Sense, are standalone devices. That means that you do not have to connect them to a computer, a phone, or a tablet, to an external device, and you don't need to learn how to use a screen reader like JAWS, NVDA, Chromevox, VoiceOver, in order to use all of their features. Now, a Braille display, on the other hand, like this Brilliant 40 here, is meant to connect to an external device. What you do is you put this display in what's called terminal mode, and in terminal mode, this display will show you in Braille whatever is on your external device, whatever is on your computer, your phone, or your tablet. Now, what does that mean? That means that you need to be able to access the screen reader on that device, right? You need to know how to use JAWS or NVDA or Chromevox or VoiceOver in order to have this Braille display work with that external device. Now, there is a lot of overlap between these two types of devices. For example, Braille notetakers usually have a terminal mode that you can use to connect to an external device, just like a Braille display. And Braille displays often have features that you can use without having to connect to a computer. For example, this Brilliant 40 has a calculator, a book reader, a simple word processor. But the difference is, what is the primary use case for this device, right? A Braille display, the primary use case is to connect to an external device, whereas a Braille note taker, the primary use case is to not connect to an external device, to use the features that are built in. So which one should you use? Well, that's going to depend on your specific situation, but what I will say is this. If the user of the device, whether that's you or your learner, if they're trying to seek employment, then they need to know how to use a computer with a Braille display. Why? Well, because when you walk into a job, the expectation is that you will be able to use a computer, not just an Android tablet with Braille. Now, does that mean that you should not use Braille notetakers? Absolutely not. Braille notetakers are great supplemental devices. But if you are going to only learn or teach one of these devices, my advice would be to learn or teach how to use a screen reader with a Braille display. Now, if you are ready to start on a Braille display, remember you have to be at least partially confident with a screen reader like JAWS, NVDA, Chromevox, VoiceOver. Now, if you don't know where to start with that, we do offer a screen reader curriculum that has two parts. The first part, we talk about reading, writing, and editing text. And the second part, we talk about the three basic internet navigation techniques that you can use to start your screen reader journey. Click the link below to get started. Now, if you enjoy free content just like this, please consider subscribing and hitting the notifications button so that when new content comes out just like this, you get notified and it shows up in your YouTube feed. Now, next week, we are continuing our electronic Braille journey. If you want to be a part of that journey, again, subscribe, notifications, and we'll see you next week for another Tech Tip Tuesday.